Okay, good morning. So today we're going to look at some further constructions, mathematical constructions, based on Twitter. And in the last video we discussed how you could calculate the set of all possible distinct tweets on Twitter. And we found the tweet number, the number, very large number of tweets that are possible. In the next few videos, we're going to find that there are a number of very interesting mathematical spaces that are useful, relevant to getting a deeper understanding of the mathematical structure of tweets. So I'm just going to enumerate some of these right now in this intro. We're going to show that you can construct a state space of tweets, and we'll talk about the idea of a state space in a little bit more detail. One way to look at it is as a big spreadsheet, but instead of a two-dimensional Excel spreadsheet with rows and columns, we're going to construct kind of a 140-dimensional spreadsheet. So each cell in the spreadsheet represent a character string or contain a character string. You know, you're just typing these characters into the cell, and that character string is a valid tweet. And so I'll call this kind of spreadsheet representation of state space of tweets, I'll call that T140. Maybe we should call it ST140, state space of tweets. Anyhow, we're also going to look at a notion of typos, typographical errors. Suppose you want to send a tweet, call it T0, and you type it in the characters you want, but you make a mistake and make a typo in one of the characters. So we can show there are actually 13,159 typos with one character wrong. You can generalize this to have multiple character typos, 2, 3, 4, until you get up to like typo 140 characters. So you meant to send a tweet of 140 characters, and somehow you've entered the wrong character in every single one of the 140 spaces. So there are types ranging from one character or zero characters, the initial tweet you were trying to send, a zero typo, so you have this idea of K typos, and K can range from 0 to 140. But for the single character mistakes, there are only 13,159 ways to do that. We're also going to generalize to tweets of n characters. A standard tweet is going to be called it has character strings consisting of 140 characters. But if you wanted to, you could make a 2-tweet or a 10-tweet or whatever you want, or maybe you could even have a Google tweet if you wanted to have a really large number of tweets. We'll find that we can introduce three different topological spaces on the tweet state space. The topological dimension of these spaces, they're all discrete topological spaces. One can assign a dimension of 0 to a discrete topological space because the elements of the topology can be put in a one-to-one correspondence with the natural numbers. A little bit confusing. I mean, we talked about a 140-dimensional spreadsheet, but because it's a discrete collection of cells, the topological dimension is 0. We can also do some fun problems, like let's make we found a really big number, the tweet number. How many possible tweets are there? And that's 94 times 95 to the 139 power. That's the number of possible distinct tweets that obey the rules of making tweets in Twitter. But you might want to generalize tweets and get, if you want to just calculate some big numbers, we could look at a really long tweet that had character strings consisting of 10 to the 100th power characters. I'm aware of the fact that this number, 10 to the 100, was originally kind of made up. They made up a name for this back in sometime in the 1950s, I think, or something. Anyway, it's the name, made up name for that number is Gogol, G-O-G-O-O-L, pronounced Gogol. The word Google with a lowercase is, you know, it's in common usage and it has this sort of connection with the word Gogol. And I've come to the conclusion that Gogol is insisting on calling this Gogol instead of Google is a bit pedantic. And I think if we use the lowercase g, you know, we're not infringing on trademarks. The name of the search engine is a capital G, Google. And, you know, by in pronunciation, they're almost indistinguishable. So I'm going to just go ahead and call 10 to the 100th a Google. And I think everybody knows what I mean. And I'm not going to pedantically insist that we call it a Gogol. But there you go. I think this Gogol is a archaic usage, and it's probably going to disappear in the next 10 years or so. Here's another thing we can do. It's quite interesting. We can actually construct a metric space of tweets. And finally, in this little preview, I'd like to talk about one way to visualize a state space is to have a machine that has a collection of distinguishable states. And so here is an example. You can kind of visualize tweets on Twitter as a collection of 140 windows or view screens and a collection of 140 reels on which all the characters, all the allowed characters for each box in this display are allowed. Tape or reel of symbols, the ASCII symbols that are allowed for the first box, and that consists of 94 characters with no spacebar entry allowed. And then for the rest of these windows here, 2 through 140, we can have reels that have 95 characters, ASCII characters, the standard allowed characters for tweets. Now, the thing that's interesting about this is that this provides a sort of a mechanical system. Each state of the system is read off, can be read off from these display screens, and each state consists of a valid tweet. So you can come up with a cute name for this. Tweet-O-matic is a good one. Now, out here in Palm Springs, we have a lot of slot machines in a lot of casinos. And I don't know if you've ever been in a slot parlor in a casino, but it is pretty hectic, and there's a lot of noises, and you hear when somebody wins a jackpot and so forth. So it occurred to me that this thing we've constructed could be a really big slot machine. Character tapes in slot machine language, these are called reels of the slot machine. And let's say you wanted to declare a winner when you get 140 characters in a row. So suppose you you pull the lever or you push the button to start these reels spinning, and then they randomly generate a collection of symbols in these windows here, and the symbols are ASCII characters. So for instance, if you got all A's in a row, that would be a winner. You got 140 A's in a row. And since there are 94 distinct characters that can allow you 140 identical characters in a row, you know, AAA, BBB, CCC, lowercase a, ampersand, and so forth, any one of those could be repeated 140 times and have a valid tweet. Well, that gives you a winner. And the thing about that, the odds of getting that are astonishingly small. If you go ahead and take a play on this slot machine with 140 windows, the Tweet-O-Matic slot machine, the probability of getting 140 in a row is 95 to the minus 139th power. So to get the probability, you take the number of ways you can get 140 in a row and divide by the total number of tweets that are available in the state space of the slot machine, and you get this small number. So if you could imagine, you could have a jackpot if you get 140 in a row of $1 trillion. Would you be willing to bet one penny for a chance of winning $1 trillion? Or suppose that somebody offered you, well, you have 1 million plays for one penny. And how long do you think it would take to plays would you have to make before you kind of had a statistically even chance of getting 140 in a row? Well, it turns out that even if you were playing 1 million plays per second, it takes many, many times the age of the universe to get up to statistical parity of having a 50-50 chance of winning the $1 trillion jackpot. So you could have everybody on Earth playing 1 million times a second for one penny and play every second of the year, and you would have almost, you know, statistically negligible probability of getting 140 in a row. But on the other hand, it's a thrill. Maybe you'll be the, you know, lucky guy and win the $1 trillion. Anyway, I thought that was sort of amusing. Anyway, that's a slide light, a little tangential comment. But this idea of having a mechanical device or some kind of electronic system, physical system, engineering system that has a finite collection of distinguishable states of the machine is one of the central applications of the mathematical theory of state spaces. So we're going to be talking about that in the next part. Well, I hope you enjoyed this brief introduction. Please leave any questions, comments, or if you can come up with some cool problems that we can solve using the state space theory we're going to develop, please go ahead and post those. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. Next, we want to look at another characterization of the state space of tweets, STW. And this is a useful notion. We can create a coordinate function that maps points in the state space to ordered 140 tuples of characters. And if the function is bijective between the coordinates and the points in the state space, this establishes the state space as a coordinate manifold. And so the coordinates are generated very simply. Given a character string that represents a tweet corresponding to a point in the state space, character string can also be viewed as an ordered set of 140 characters. This ordered 140 tuple is written like numerical coordinates, let's say in Rn. This is instead of numbers, we have the characters in the Twitter character set. So we can write this out as a Cartesian product. The coordinate generating function maps the state space of tweets to a Cartesian product of 140 characters. So I don't want to say it's obvious, but I think if you can leave this as a homework problem to show that F is bijective and F inverse exists and so on. So this establishes another interesting property of the state space of tweets. We have a coordinate system covers all the points allowed in the Twitter state space. And there's another interesting thing about this. By looking at these coordinates, it's pretty easy to calculate how many points there are in the space. It's just you have to sum over all possible coordinates. This is another way to calculate the tweet number, is simply count up the number of 140 tuples of the allowed characters in Twitter. And I'll leave that as a, you know, do it your home problem or something. Okay, next up, we have a vector space characterization of the state space. So instead of points, we have state vectors. Points in the state space become vectors. So let's go down here and take a look. Preview this. So we're going to establish a vector space of tweets, and each tweet is a state vector. You can consider it as a state of the Tweet-O-matic machine that we were talking about in the visualization. But here's how you write out a tweet as an element of a linear space. So you have 140 basis vectors, B1 through B140, and these are such that they span the space of tweets. Then that establishes a linear space of tweets, or a vector space of tweets, as long as we have a scalar algebra for the coordinates alpha k. So we're talking about a vector space over a field of scalars, and the scalars are going to be the characters in tweet. So alpha here, this is an element of C94, and alpha 2 is an element of C95, and so on. In order to have a official vector space, the alphas have to obey a scalar algebra. And it's pretty easy to establish a scalar algebra on these coordinates, and you can get a hint from the reals we had that were on the Tweet-O-matic. You know, you have these characters on a reel that can rotate around, and there are 95 characters available. So this is sort of a hint that there's a cyclic group representation of those reels. And so I'm not going to go into this, but the cyclic group of order 95 is an example of that would be modular addition mod 95. If you're familiar with additive algebra using modular arithmetic, that is an example of the cyclic group of order 95. And so in order to generate addition of characters, we're simply going to number the characters on the reel from 1 to 95, let's say, and then we'll do group algebra on those numbers and construct new numbers in the range of 1 to 95, and then they will correspond to the new characters. So all this kind of works out, and you can construct a cyclic group of additive algebra. And I'm not going to specify the multiplicative algebra here, but for our purposes, we are going to just need additive algebra. And so this, the fact that we have a algebra of characters allows us to construct a vector space of tweets. And so individual tweets are state vectors in the space that can be represented in this fashion right here. Now, we're going to show what some of this is good for a little bit later, but I think that's about enough for now. I hope you enjoyed this brief walkthrough. Please leave any questions or comments on YouTube.